what to do, and I told Lou Salmon it could be on record.
Well, bring it, I'll get it to John.
There are a couple of problems. They had so many more people.
It's going to get bigger, I worry.
Well, I told him that what we have to do next year, and he said we'll take care of it. I said, you want to get two big boats that have warm cabins. Well, no, not for spectators, for swimmers that are out, because we hauled on about 25 people. We couldn't make it. About halfway through, I mean, they were done. So if you pull them out of the water and put them in my boat, it's no good. You got to get them in something bigger that's got some warm and hot coffee or something. And we did have one sailboat there, one big boat. So we had everybody take
it. Nobody ever took it.
They need more than that. They need at least two.
And last year, see, we always have our boat
hauled out 25 years.
Well, last year, we only had
one. Jeff, what was that about?
Last year, they never got two. This year, they were
Jeff was with me.
Maybe.
All right, there
you go.
Okay. Anyhow, there were a lot. Last year, we did a lot. We hauled one guy out.
These
put him back in the water.
Yeah,
they did. But this year, they have so many. A lot of these guys are not shaped, they can't beat us.
Have this event, it can get everybody out.
I figure I'd say, but you let me know.
We have two members.
I know we had one. I know Jim Tall was one, but I don't know who the other guy was.
Yeah.
I tried to find out. I tried to get Jim on the phone, but I was going to put an article in the Telltale, and he went, well, Playcheck didn't send me to Scott.
Queen, she was. corpse I'd ever seen. I think of Elsie to this very day. I remember how she turned to me and said, what good is sitting alone in your room? I hear the music play. Life is a cabaret, old chum, so come to the cabaret. Put down your knitting, the book,
duty tonight. It's a pleasure to welcome you all. We've got a good show for you. We've got a great cast. And as you look very carefully behind the makeup, you might see somebody you thought you knew. I'm going to do the thank yous now, a couple of very important ones, because I always get kind of rattled at the end of a show and forget all about it. I'd like to thank a wonderful gal, Paula Hansen, who has done all the makeup for us these past two nights. Paula, will you come out,
hey,
please,
Paula,
with your powder?
She's the reason our guys look a lot better than they usually do.
We've got a great stage manager. He's just absolutely marvelous. Matthew Gorton.
Hey, Matthew.
He gives us light, he gives us sound, he also gives us a lot of moral support.
A very big thank you tonight goes to the Corinthian Catering Company and its president. What is his president's name? Jack Cooper. For their terrific support, they gave us a lovely donation to keep this show going. Thanks a lot, guys and girls. Our musical people tonight are really the tops. Been with us from the beginning. There's Elaine Lang at the piano here. Scar,
hey.
Harry Blake,
hey.
And Bill Cannon.
Hey.
This show doesn't need a roadmap. It's very simple. It's a variety of songs, both old and new, sung by a variety of people in a variety of attitudes. So we're going to get on with it now. So I want to introduce you to Barbara Klein, who's your master of ceremonies for the evening.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Fred Madison, who will sing the beautiful Music of the Night from Phantom of the Opera.
Heightens each sensation, darkens
lethal senses abandon their defenses. Unfurls its splendor, grasp it, sense it, tremulous and tender. Turn your face away from the garish light of day. Turn your thoughts away from golden feeling night, and listen to the music of
on the day Come fly with me, we'll fly away. If you can use some exotic booze, there's a bar in far Bombay. Come on, fly with me, fly with, fly away. Come fly with me, we'll float down to Peru. In Llama Land, there's a one-man band, and he'll toot his flute for you. Come on, fly with me, we'll float down in the blue. Once I get you up there, where the air is rarefied, we'll just glide, starry-eyed. Once I get you up there, I'll be holding you so near. You may hear angels cheer just because we're together, weather-wise, such a lovely day. Just say those words and we'll beat those birds down to Acapulco Bay. It's perfect for a flying honeymoon, they say. Come on, fly with me, we'll fly, we'll fly. Once I get you up there, where the air is rarefied, we'll just glide, petrified. Once I get you up there, I'll be holding you so near. You may hear angels cheer just because we're together. Weather-wise, it's such a lovely day. Just say the word and I'll beat your bird down to Acapulco Bay. It's perfect for a flying honeymoon, they say. Come on, fly with me, we'll fly, we'll fly. Pack up and fly away. Don't tell your papa.
Shark has pretty teeth, dear, and he shows them pearly white. Just a jackknife has old Mac gear, and he keeps it out of sight. When the shark bites, scarlet billows start to spread. Fancy gloves, though, where's Mac Heath, dear? So there's not a trace of red. On a sidewalk, Sunday morning, who's in what? Someone sneaking round the corner. Could that someone be Mac the Knife? From a tugboat on the river, a cement bag's dropping down. The cement's just for the weight, dear. Bet you Mackie's back in town. Eddie Fisher has disappeared, dear, after drawing out all his cash. And Mackie spends like a sailor. Did our boy do something rash? Diana Fisher, Esther Lerner, J. Jackie Taylor, and Elsa Leaf Scar. Oh, the line forms on the right, dear. Now that Mackie is back in town. Oh, the line forms on the right, dear. Now that Mackie, he's back in town.
Love of my own. City. That's where the Dalton boys used to shoot up the bank whenever they went in for a withdrawal. And Dodge City, where White Era held forth, and I was about halfway in between. Anthony was small. We had a population of 1,231. And was that way for years. It just seemed like every time someone was born, somebody left town. Well, anyway. We had a lot of Indians. And they were something. And southeast, about 35 miles, was Cherokee, Oklahoma. And that was the head of the Cherokee Nation of Indians, and Will Rogers came from there. And then just south of Anthony was the Oklahoma Territory, and Judge Roy Bean held forth there. And although he wasn't an Indian, you didn't mess around with the judge. Then just west of Anthony was Kiowa, and that's where the Kiowa Indians were. And then Medicine Lodge is where the peace treaty was. Well, Anthony played football with Kiowa and Medicine Lodge. And we tried real hard to win, because losing was kind of a hair-raising experience. In Kansas, the wind blows, it's hot, and every once in a while, the wind blows all the time. And sometimes when it blows a little extra, why, it takes all the topsoil, blows it right across Oklahoma, down into the panhandle of Texas. But not to worry, because two or three days later, blow it right back. When I was when I was young, like the radio didn't work at all in the daytime. I don't know, it had something to do with the electricity in the air or something. And at night, why, it was marginal. So the only time we ever had any fun was when Bob Wills and his Texas Playboys would come to town, and they'd come about once a month and play in the community center, and which was really a basketball court. And because Anthony, well, all of Kansas for that matter, was dry, and when I mean dry, I mean they didn't sell any booze, and the WCTU made sure that everybody was pure, and all the bootleggers supported them. I mean, you know, that's what happened. So anyway, Bob Wills and his gang would show up, and they'd play a set, and everybody was really straight-laced, you know, and they'd do some kind of a jazz square dance or something, and they were really great, and then they'd have an intermission. And then everybody went out and sat in their car and drank bootleg booze and hot Coca-Cola. And then they came back and it was a whole different party. I mean, they were hooting and hollering. A friend of mine, Harold Hill, so I'll never forget, confided in me. He said, you know, I really don't know how to dance, but I can sure intermission. Well, that's about the story. Out there in the plains and everything you can imagine, dusty and dirty, and I lived with my parents, and we all lived with my grandfather in this old house, big old house, everybody was poor. You know, there was the land was poor and everything, and my grandfather was poor, and my father was poor. My mother was poor. The maid upstairs was poor. The cook was poor. The gardener was poor. I'm telling you, it was poor back then. Well, I think we better get to it.
A shanty in old shanty town. It's so shanty, it touches the ground. But that tumble-down shack by an old railroad track, like a millionaire's mansion. me back. It's more than a palace. If I were a king, it's more than a palace. It's my everything. There's a queen waiting there with her silvery hair in a shanty in old Shanty Town. There's a shanty in the town on a little plot of ground where the green grass grows all around, and the roof's so worn, so badly torn that it's tumbled to the ground. Just a little old shack, and it's built way back, about 25 feet from a railroad track. Lingers on my mind most all the time, keeps calling me back to the little old shack. I'd be just as sassy as Haile Selassie if I were king of me. Boots on top, writing on the wall, wouldn't mean a thing, not a doggone thing. There's a queen waiting there in a rocking chair, blowing her top for the gators there, looking all around and trucking on down, cause I gotta get back to my shanty town. Yeah. It's a shanty in old shanty town.
of course, but keep them a horse before the car. So what's the heck's the use of crying? Why should we curse? We gotta get better, cause we can't get worse. Can't graduate. We've got heart. We've got heart. We've got heart.
It's been a vintage year at the winery, boys. And here is Elsa Lee, who will challenge you to peel me a grape.
Oh, yeah. Oh.
Keep talking.
glad the many millions of Annabelles and Lillians would be to capture me. But you had such persistence, you wore down my resistance. I fell, and it was swell. I'm your big and brave and handsome Romeo. How I won you, I shall never, never know. It's not that I'm attractive, but oh, my heart grew active when you came into view. I've got a crush on you, sweetie pie, all the day and night time. Hear me sigh, I never had the least notion that I could fall with so much emotion. Could you coo? Could you care for a lovely cottage that we could share? The world will pardon my mush, but I've got a crush, got a crush, my baby, on you. Could you care for a cozy cottage we could share? The world will pardon my mush, but I've got a crush, my baby, on you. Cole Porter, and I hope you like it. I've got you, I've got you under my skin. I've got you deep in the heart of me, so deep in my heart. You're really a part of me. I've got you under my skin. I tried so not to give in. I said to myself, this affair never can go so well. But why should I try to resist when, baby, I know so well? I got you under my skin. I'd sacrifice anything, come what might, for the sake of having you near, in spite of a warning voice comes in the night and repeats in my ear. Don't you know, little fool, you never can win. Use your mentality, wake up to reality. But each time that I do, just the thought of you makes me stop before I begin. 'Cause I've got you under my skin. Thank you. advice, anything, come what might, for the sake of having you near, in spite of a warning voice, comes in the night and repeats in my ear. Don't you know, little fool, you never can win. Use your mentality, wake up to reality. And each time that I do, just the thought of you makes me stop before I begin, 'cause I've got you under my skin. Yes, I've got you under my skin. I got you under my skin. Round of applause to Judy Hall and her band. That was the last number. They did a great job. Judy Hall, Espen Skar, Phil Canada, and Harry Blunt.
That's the bestest band, what am I, honey lamb? Big threat. I've got the feed box noise. It says his great-grandfather was equipoised. Shows class. This guy says the horse shows class. If he says the horse shows class.
I got the horse right here. The name is Paul Revere. And here's a guy that says if the weather's clear,
I'm can do. Valentine, cause can all the do. Morning line, the
this guy says the horse can do.
Five to nine.
But how about he says the horse can do.
New York.
bites. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. You've been an absolutely hot audience. Now, before we sing our last song to you, for you, I'd like to bring back the Sons of the Sea. Let us clap for them, show our appreciation, their guests from the St. Francis Yacht Club. We really loved you.
Yes.
Thank you.
And now, please welcome the cast of Cabaret by the Bit.
Yes.
Let's go on with the show.
myself here, but I think this audience was a wonderful audience for all of you.
Sure.
And you give your hearts to this, and I don't know, but I'm exploding with appreciation, I'm sure all of you. And Jackie Taylor pulled this thing together as director of this whole event. I couldn't be more pleased and more proud as a Corinthian.
We didn't even know she could sing.
Thank you so much. It's truly wonderful. Thank you so much from all of us. You just gave us a joyful evening.
Thank you.